French President Emmanuel Macron will host world leaders and experts in Paris this Thursday and Friday for a climate summit aimed at pinning down a roadmap for easing the debt burdens of low-income countries while freeing up more funds for climate financing. Attendees will try to forge a top-level consensus on how to advance a number of currently struggling initiatives for countries battered by extreme weather and climate change. The latest Global Climate Risk Index showed that Puerto Rico and Myanmar were the worst affected by extreme weather events from 2000 to 2019, followed by Haiti, the Philippines, Mozambique, the Bahamas, Bangladesh, Pakistan, Thailand, and Nepal. Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky admits progress has been slower than desired 2 weeks into their counteroffensives against Russian forces. This report takes us to the edges of the combat zone where soldiers and locals say fighting is brutal and slow against an enemy that is heavily fortified for battle.
Like super adequate.
On the edge of one part of Ukraine's 1,000-kilometer-long front line, medics prepare for injured soldiers to be rushed in from battle. They say the fighting in this area is different from other major Ukrainian pushes to retake areas occupied by Russia. For example, they say they're seeing more bullet wounds because the fighting here is closer than in previous battles where most injuries came from bombings. Ukraine has retaken several villages in the past 2 weeks, but soldiers say the movement is slow because Russians have occupied much of this area for at least a year. They have had time to build strong fortifications and get to know the region. But locals in the villages near the front line say they are starting to feel some relief as bombings get further and further away.
Some locals tell us that they expect this part of the war may go on a long time because, as they say, they are now fighting not kilometer by kilometer, but meter by meter. Reporting from Komar in eastern Ukraine, Heather Murdoch, VOA News.
The U.S. first couple welcomes Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi at the White House. Modi has been to the U.S. 5 times since becoming prime minister in 2014, but this trip is his first with the full diplomatic status of a state visit. Biden and Modi are expected to deepen defense and technology cooperation between the two countries, despite lingering concerns about human rights in India. Biden is under pressure by his fellow Democrats to raise the issue with the Indian leader amid concerns about democratic backsliding in India under Modi's ruling party. The two leaders will deliver remarks and take questions from journalists on Thursday. Human rights could be one of the topics of the press conference. The White House seeking to smooth tensions with China just days after the visit of its top diplomat Antony Blinken to Beijing. That's after U.S. President Joe Biden compared Chinese leader Xi Jinping to embarrassed dictators following the passage of a Chinese spy balloon over U.S. airspace earlier this year. Now, a Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesperson says Biden's comments seriously violate diplomatic protocol and severely infringe on China's political dignity. The spokesperson also denounced Biden's remarks as a blatant political provocation. A White House official, however, insists the president speaking candidly about China at the event should come as no surprise. The official adds the president believes that diplomacy is the responsible way of managing tensions. A French robot joins the hunt to find the missing submersible during the Titanic wreck. It can give deeper than other equipment now at the site, but as the Victor 6000 isn't scheduled to arrive until late Wednesday, giving it a limited window to provide assistance before the Thursday morning deadline when the Titan's air supply is expected to run out. Operated by a 25-man crew, the robot is equipped with remotely controlled arms that can cut cables or perform maneuvers to release a stuck vessel. The Victor's crew joins teams from the U.S., Canada, and France, which have been searching the area roughly the size of Lebanon. Now, the U.S. Coast Guard has deployed remotely operated vehicles in the area where Canadian aircraft recorded noises, but have found no signs of the Titan yet. The Coast Guard says analysis of the noises has been inconclusive. At least 37 are now injured following an explosion that ripped through the busy Latin Quarter of Paris. The blast started fires and collapsed the facade of a building housing a design school popular with foreign students. Police say four of the injured are in critical condition. Rescue workers also searching for two missing people feared buried under the rubble. The Paris prosecutor's office says it's still too early to say what caused the blast, but a local deputy mayor has referred to it as a gas explosion, and witnesses have told local media there was a strong smell of gas moments before the blast. The Latin Quarter is famed as the home of many expatriates and French artists over the years. U.S. Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell affirms more rate hikes are on the table as the fight against inflation still has a long way to go. Speaking at his biannual testimony in Congress, Powell explained the Fed's decision to pause rate hikes last week as an exercise in prudence that will allow policymakers to gather more information before deciding on further increases.
Inflation has moderated somewhat since the middle of last year. Nonetheless, inflation pressures continue to run high, and the process of getting inflation back down to 2% has a long way to go. Despite elevated inflation, longer-term inflation expectations appear to remain well anchored, as reflected in a broad range of surveys of households, businesses, and forecasters, as well as measures from financial markets. We have been seeing the effects of our policy tightening on demand in the most interest rate-sensitive sectors of the economy. It will take time, however, for the full effects of monetary restraint to be realized, especially on inflation.
U.S. inflation eased to 4% in May from 4.9% in April, but core CPI came in at 5.3%. That's more than double the Fed's 2% target. The death toll from a riot at a women's prison in Honduras rises to 46. Honduras President Xiomara Castro says the riot had been planned by gang members with the knowledge of guards. She vows to take drastic measures to address the deaths. Identifying victims has been a challenge, with many burned to death. Honduras has a history of prison riots. Now, the gangs involved in Tuesday's violence have long battled for control of the drug trafficking and extortion industries. Castro's office is set to announce new measures to combat organized crimes. More and more appliances are becoming smart. Soon you'll be able to add toilets to that list, which are angling to become your most personal health monitor. Take a look.
Each day, vast amounts of valuable health information are flushed down toilets. Stanford School of Medicine's Sungmin Park says there is an opportunity to improve health by closely monitoring human waste.
Here's a prototype that we work on.
Park is developing a smart toilet that can gather visual information about a user's stool and send it to healthcare providers.
And we're looking at those excreta with computer vision and artificial intelligence to tell the early disease detection or even prevention of disease.
The camera is located right behind this housing here.
Park is working with South Korean manufacturer Ezen to develop the first consumer version, which will be an add-on to an existing toilet with the capability to send basic health and nutrition advice to a user's phone. Park says future versions could monitor many conditions and even detect early signs of cancer. U-Scan, a device from French company Withings, samples urine.
Urine is an amazing source of health information. Urine contains up to 3,000 chemical compounds.
The system uses replaceable cartridges with enough tests for 90 days.
All you have to do is just to urinate, and that's it.
A tiny pump is heat activated and delivers drops of urine to a test strip,
which will react with urine and generate a color change, which we detect with an optical sensor.
Test results appear on the app within minutes. Cartridges for monitoring fertility and nutrition will be available first. Tech is coming to the toilet, but it remains to be seen if users are ready to welcome these innovations into their most private routines. Matt Dibble for VOA News, Palo Alto, California.